Statistics indicate that Uganda currently imports 99% of vaccines used by its citizens. Whereas the sector offers a huge investment opportunity, experts argue that a revisit into the investment and industrial policies could spin the wheel in the right direction. These views were highlighted during the High-Level Policy Symposium on Trade-Related Policies and Negotiations and Vaccine Manufacturing Access in Africa.
As Africa, we need to build our capacity to be able to manufacture our vaccines, and we can be able to do it. It's doable. The Africa Union came up with a commitment that by 2040, will be accessing 60% of our vaccine will be internally generated. Today, 99% of the vaccines, we get it from outside. So it's very ambitious that by 2040 we are going to be getting 60% of our vaccines.
Can't be talking about local vaccine manufacturing if we don't have technology transfer. And so we're looking at the nexus between vaccine manufacturing, but also industrial and investment policies and how they can facilitate all how we can leverage on the same to achieve our aspirations in line with manufacturing our vaccines locally.
The Minister of Science and Technology, however, notes that African countries should consider usage of innovation to boost vaccine production. She is, however, against the innovation of copying and pasting, which she says is expensive.
The technologies are seen as expensive, but they're expensive to us because, one, we have not really paid attention to them. We've not tried to build them. We are trying to copy and paste. But if we take time and think through, then we come up with ways of producing vaccines cheaper, producing vaccines more cost-effectively. And we have demonstrated this in Uganda. The leg we have moved with our vaccines is costing only about 10% of what is reported to cost outside.
The outbreak of COVID-19 pandemic confirmed that African countries were short of the volume of vaccines needed as they fully relied on foreign countries to donate.